Okay, the second part would be about steel extension, seeing three more things. Four. One, how to create a page. Say if you want a new CiviCRM slash my own page extension instead of modifying an existing one. How to create your own API. And or to use CVisualize. We have until when?
12:45, half an hour.
Half an hour, okay. So, what is that saying? So that's another extension this one is just a simple page where you display the list of participants in an event. Or let me demo that.
You increase the font size.
That better?
Also the terminal.
Okay. I'm sure I can do that.
Control and plus if it's known terminal.
Nope.
Yeah. That's better.
Okay. So what it does is creating a new page, event/live/. And so that's the one event, and it displays the list of participants, and you can take the participant and generate the badge. So feature, not very interesting so far, but that's something I've developed as a Drupal module and that I'm migrating to CV now. That's really nice what you can do on HTML for the badges. You can really print your badge using HTML only, and so it means that you can load once the list of all participants and have registration desks that directly print all of that. I did that for a political party, and they had more than 1,000 participants and 7 rows of registration, and it worked quite well, and printed the badge and update automatically when you print, and that changed the status attended. Yeah, so instead of printing the 1,000, because they have like 2,000 registration, but only half of them are going to come.
Right, yeah.
So they just print it when they come.
Yeah.
So come back to that extension later on. It will do something useful at one point. Mm-hmm. And so same thing with civics. You have green on yellow, it's lovely. You have a generate page, and you say, okay, that's the URL of the page, so cvcrm/event/live, that's the class to manage the page you want. Generate these two files, and you can just modify them. So that would create that PHP, where you say, I want to get the param, and if the event ID is missing, display an error message, fetch a few more data. In another way of fetching data with the API, you have a object-oriented one, API, and the entity and the action, just to show different ways of using this. Oh, that's no, that's since you were unborn. You need to add that extra one. So the fun part, side comment, but the fun part with that one is depending on how you instantiate that class. Where is it? So by default, that's just a wrapper, object-oriented wrapper around the normal, but you can instantiate it and say that's going to call a remote CiviCRM over REST. And so that's the same code after that, but that would do separate requests. So bit of PHP, there is a new class that extends the page. Within that, you fetch the data, you look at the parameters given, and you run, and it will automatically take the template that you have that matches the name. You can customize, but by default, it's going to take the right one and display it with all the parameters that I've put. So for instance, the parameter total, which is going to be the number of participants, or a JSON containing the list of participants. And then from the TPL, you can display these values and initiate the select and do whatever you want. And no big reason to fetch the data sometime from PHP, assign it to the template, or use the API to fetch data directly from Smarty. That's whatever you feel. And again, these three files, when you use Civics and say generate a page, it will create these three files, the PHP class that is called, the template file that the PHP will use by default, and the XML that defines a new URL, the new route, saying if you go to cvcrm/event/live, then call that class. So I said, this URL called that class being the PHP one that generated. Again, by default generated by Civics, you can just use that. Make sense?
The access arguments, are they listed somewhere? Like, because I sort of recognize that from Drupal, but of course CiviCRM is ambiguous. What's the word? Doesn't mind whether it's Drupal or WordPress. And is that
So the permissions for the access arguments, where do we have a list of all of that?
They're shared across all the CMSs, so it's defined once in core permissions or something, okay. And then all the CMSs pick up those that list and generate their own permissions from them. So I think if you delve deep enough into CRM core permissions or something, it sounds a list of them.
Sure. In the somewhere in one of the PHP file, you have that list. But I was thinking, is there an easy way to get access that? Not from the top of my head. And you kind of can create your own permission as well in the extensions, but that's a well less traveled road. And I mean, anyway, in the PHP, you can add extra tests on the access. If you are a participant to the event, then display it, otherwise don't, and so on. Do I go too fast, or that's... This one is using an API somewhere. Maybe that's from the template. Okay, I will find it 2 seconds.
Capital G.
Oh yes, that's here. So I fetch the list of participants with extra information. So for that list, I wanted to be able to fetch the participant and fetch as well the organization they belong to, the gender, their gender, and so on. And by default, that's not something that's done in one single API call. So either you chain and saying that fetch the participant for each participant, fetch the contact to get the gender. But that would be, as if you have a few hundred or a few thousand participants, that could be quite slow because that's a lot of requests. The faster way, it would be you create a new API getful and write your own SQL query that automatically join and fetch exactly the data you want. Same thing, Civics, you can generate an API. So in that case, that was the getful API. Yes, it's in the extension. In the extension, I have one new page with the template associated that we've shown. And now this one is a new API that participant get full. So same principle, you put that in the right place. Civics does it. And in that file, you say, that's the new API I create, participant get full. And you can put directly the query you want. Or basically, you can write any code you want. As soon as you finish by saying, at the end, create the right return params with the list of values, then you're good. And so you can do that either adding an extra action on an existing entity, which is the case here. Participant is something that's standard, and getFull is my custom one. Or you can create your own abstract entities. And then, well, everything that works with the normal API via REST, via AJAX, via PHP, via Smarty works directly for your new one. And that's a nice trick to. Okay, clear so far? Again, nothing too much magic, you just need to put the right name. Civics generates it automatically for you, and you just fill and put the query or do the magic you want inside that. Okay. Last thing I wanted to show you is CVisualize and how you can extend that. Are you using it? Do you know that extension? Or
I've used it, but I've noticed that it's, last time I checked in, it was several versions higher than the one that I'm using because I picked it up a few years ago.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm interested to see what's new.
It's probably a few new visualization, a few new reports. But what I'm going to see today is how you can extend and make your own report on your own extension. So the one I did was actually one that exists already in the default one. So we are a bit cheating, but we can. So that's one that displays the number of participants when they registered, that's a default one, but we're going to walk through that. And then by gender and status and event paid and the list. And then you can automatically filter, I'm only interested by the registered one and the mail one, and it's adjusting the list and all the other graphs. Okay. So to do that, you need two things. One, define the query that will fetch all the participants grouped by the date of registration and the gender and the participant status. And second, the template that will contain the JavaScript that displays the pies and so on. Oops, sorry, this one. So the query is the easiest. You put the folder queries. Into that, you put either an SQL, if you don't need any parameter, or a JSON, if you need to be able to put a parameter, like in that case, which event you want to display. And you put the query inside that. So that's the query. The only thing is that here you have a filter where the event ID is, and that's the parameter that you get. And by default, the slash last part of the path is the ID that will be assigned. Okay, so in that case, we just fetch all the participants from that ID. If you have bigger database, like on the list of all your contacts or all your donation, fetching your several hundred thousand contacts would be too big. So you would group that by, say, gender and the months of creation. So whatever you want to display, just group them directly. Okay, so you have the query here. And what you need to do is the second part, the template that you're going to use to display. So everything you put into a template database, and then the template is going to be directly accessible there in the URL. Okay? So if you create if you do slash AAA, you will have the template displayed. I'm losing you, or? And inside that, you put your HTML with the thing. I want the pie chart here. I want the graph about date there. I want the list of participants there. And you use that. So that's calling the SQL query that we have written with the param, the ID. So that will call the queries slash event participant.json and put as event ID the ID that we have. Call the SQL, get the result, and put that into a JSON that then you can use and display the way you want. You can use that if you want to have your own custom SQL. Otherwise, you can just use the normal API to fetch existing entities. So in that case, that would be the list of roles or the list of status. And then basically you massage the data a bit, and where is the graph? And that's using DC, which is a JavaScript library, and you say create a new line chart or pie chart, put it in that HTML, in that div or wherever you want in the page. And then let's take an example. So you say that's the size of the pie, and it's using that that data, basically grouped by group. So it's going to use the data about the gender, you group by gender, so male, female, and display the pie with that. You are, I'm assuming, not familiar with DC at all. So that's a really nice library, JavaScript library. You can have lots of data, like hundreds of thousands of rows of JSON, and process them in, it doesn't take too long. And that's quite good at saying, I want on the list of participants, so the SQL we saw, the list of participants, I want to group all the male, female, and trans into separate groups and put that into a pie. So that's what these two lines do, saying here I am interested by the gender. So I'm using the gender ID. And then once I'm saying how which data I want to analyze, which column I want to analyze, say I just want to do a reduce. So just simply count. So this is the most common and easier one. But you could say, for instance, I'm interested by the amount. Say that you have a participation fee somewhere. Instead of just counting the number of male or number of female participants, you might want to count how much they paid. And in that case, you would use the amount instead of just the reduced count. That's by default just one. And that's pretty much always the same principle. Say, this is the column, this is the attribute in my JSON I want to analyze. This is how I want to group it. And then I want to display it as a line chart or as a pie or as in one of the existing graphs. I would suggest you to look at existing once in CiviCRM, but if you have something that you like and is almost what you want but not quite, so for instance what we did was we kind of liked what we had, the default one for the contacts, but we were not interested by all the contacts but only the contact in the group members. So what you do is just copy the template of contact, copy the query of contact, and make your own query with your own template and decide, I'm not interested by that graph, and you remove it and put another one. And that's a nice way to have your own report and visualization. Okay. And that was pretty much all what I wanted to show you on the second part. That was it.
Just a quick question.
Mm-hmm.
And I thought it might be an interesting exercise. So we might spit out, someone says the permission class is involved. How do we go from hearing that to actually getting the information? And I feel like there are a couple different paths you might take to get that information. So it might be a useful exercise.
Mm-hmm.
Rep. Excellent. So we might do a recursive rep in the CiviCRM folder for capital permission, because the class is always going to be capitalized, and then that'll help us find the file name.
Also the permission. We find quite a lot of stuff, I guess.
So pick an obscure permission, and then you won't find quite as many.
Yeah.
Okay. So rep is turning a whole lot of data. So maybe we
want something. Not grep, that's Silver Surfer, AG. That's an awesome one.
Maybe instead of going with a grep, which looks inside the content of every file, we could do find and look for a file with that name. Because classes have that name.
And that's...
I think it's a space instead of equals. Yeah, a capital perm star. Okay, so that's a smaller list. And they said permission class, so it's probably not the folder in the middle. CRM core permission? Does that seem like a good guess?
That's...
I'm biased because I happen to know that that's the right file.
Good suggestion.
But it's probably not the API subscriber or the WordPress thing or just about contacts. So yeah, let's take a look at that.
And so we know we had access.
All right, so that's interesting. Something about access to CRM is coming up.
Lots of custom things, and we still don't have the full list.
Maybe if we did a more complete permission, like access city mail.
That's this right one? Yes. Possibly. Okay, let's grab them. And what's the magic?
Dash L, lowercase. I guess LR.
Yeah,
that
did.
And CRM core permission comes up again. And oh, yeah, so does that other file. In this context, do you happen to know Drupal? Like so in Drupal, you would know that hook permission is where permissions are. Okay, so we've been searching a little bit on this. We can do it a little more, but if we don't find something, then we might take that Drupal angle, our knowledge about hook permission, and use that to get the information.
Yeah.
Because under hook permission, you know there's going to be a function that's named module CiviCRM underscore permission. And if you call that, it gives a list of all the available permissions, right? So drush would be used to call that function. Or if you have the CV command installed, you could use that. Do you have a cat CV? Or,
no.
So if you said drush EV, which is short for evaluate, and then in quotation marks, print R, and pass in the data from CiviCRM underscore permission.
Done like that?
And then open and close. Well, we can try it, and it'll get some error message. XD, right? Or
Well, since we're Drupal experts, we know that it's a hook, it's a function, which means that it's not a variable. It means, so we replace the dollar sign, and at the end, we put an open and close parenthesis.
Sorry, I didn't get you. That's French key.
Oh.
Yes.
All right. So we want an open parenthesis and a closed parenthesis here.
Okay.
You've got dollar at the beginning of CiviCRM permission.
And we're missing a closed parenthesis. Because it's print R of CiviCRM, and then we need a semicolon. Oh, is Civi not enabled on this thing?
That's more like the screen I normally see.
Ah, there we go.
Three in less than. Ta-da! So yes, you have.
There's also a tool called Psych, P-S-Y-S-H, which is a command line tool that allows you to run PHP functions interactively. And there's it's also a library, so you can use Psych with Drush, and you can use it with CV.
Okay.
And so if you do CV space CLI, it'll open up this command line. If you, and you can just type in arbitrary PHP code. It will have CiviCRM bootstrapped already, because that's what CV is for. And
CV, did you say?
Yeah.
The two characters, C and V.
Correct.
Yeah.
Because it's Unix and it's the command line, you want something easy to type.
So
where'd
you get that from?
You get it from GitHub.
Right. No, sorry, I was just going to say the only way to get the list of permissions is just to look in Drupal people permissions. That would load up all those CiviCRM permissions.
Yeah, except they could have been mapped to different things in Drupal as in different things in WordPress. Like when you see a permission written in Civi, it's native to Civi and there's no. In Drupal, it's probably going to be the same.
Yeah, in Drupal, but I don't know what
that is. But I think WordPress would.
That's a good point.
I'm not sure if it changes either. I thought it does label it now. It's like in Drupal 6, it would have shown the code name for the permission. But now, in newer versions, maybe it shows a pretty label.
I think, yeah, it can be translated, so therefore, it's probably not the real name. Which is always hell when you end up using an extension in a language you don't know, saying, I am assuming it's Access CV Mail. and maybe just to wrap up the extensions, you were mentioning two features that be useful. One, the not linked object. When you want to instantiate, for instance, an activity type or load a case type. So you can either have an XML doing that, or the linked object, the name escapes me right now.
Yeah, I can't remember what it's called. I just remember spending ages writing code that went, does this activity type exist? No, let's make it. Does this custom field
right.
exist? No, let's
so
make
yeah,
it.
So yeah, that's.
And then I found that in other extensions, there was an XML file that looked like it was doing exactly the same thing, but.
Is that the bundle?
Exactly. It's that, no, it's the generate custom XML. And if we look at the help on that.
That's the syntax? No.
I think that works. It means generate only. So it takes two arguments. You can either give a list of custom data groups or a list of profile forms, and it will spit out the XML for those things. With option values, this XML location does support option values. There's just no command line tool that exports the option values.
Is this, where would I find documentation for that XML file?
For the XML schema, I'm not sure there's documentation. What you would do is generate some examples and compare the examples.
Yeah.
So does that automatically create those custom data fields when you install the extension?
Yes, that's usually how it's done. You can also do it through the API.
And does that handle updating the time the XML changes?
No, it does not. It handles initial installation only. Yeah.
And do they get updated?
Because the thing is, when you change schema, there might be a semantic difference.
Yeah.
Right? Like if you're changing from numeral 2 to textual TWO, then you need some logic.
So I guess you start it off in there and then you can update it using update.
Exactly.
And you have MGD, that stands for managed something.
That's the one, MGD. Millennium Development Goals or something. that was the thing I came across.
Yeah.
So yeah, you defined, okay, that may be not the best example, but you defined things you need, like entities you need, and when you install the extension, it will take care of creating them.
And this will update automatically.
It will, yeah.
There are policies you can set. There's a wiki page which describes hook underscore CiviCRM underscore managed, which is the thing that powers this, and it describes all the main options you can pass in there. So you can set an option which says, never update it, that's what you prefer, or you can say keep it around even after the extension has been deleted, that sort of thing.
That's useful.
Another thing that's tangentially related to, you know, writing some code where it checks to see if the activity type exists and then creates it and then checks and then creates, there's a generic option on the API called options.match, which will search for an existing record based off of some key. If it finds that record, then it will do an update on that record. If it doesn't find that record, then it will create.
Yeah. I think I wanted to allow, if it was an activity type, I wanted to allow the possibility for the users to further extended it beyond, and so you know, I couldn't assume complete ownership of it.
In most of the entities, you have the internal name, like machine name, that the end user cannot modify.
Yeah,
so you can rely on that. And there are a few entities that you don't have that, but less and less. Tags, you don't have them. But most of them, you have some kind of key that's unique and not that the end user cannot change. And bundles, what that?
Can you show me your civics help screen? So I have a feeling that you've got an oldish version of civics here.
No, maybe.
Because this is the generate bundle is something that Symfony framework.
Oh, yeah, okay. No, that's okay. No.
We don't use it. And in newer versions, a lot of the things that Symfony framework provided are worked out because they don't really apply.
Okay. So, yes, these .mgd are quite nice. The only canvas is that everything works or nothing works, and if you have a problem in one of the 20 stuff you create, then it's not ideal. So that's one of the benefits of doing manually with PHP. You can more easily say, okay, if this one doesn't work, that's kind of okay. If this one does not, then yeah, and processing the errors is, well, obviously you get more flexibility if you write your own code.
Yeah. With some use to VX,
how is that pronounced?
Civics. Okay, so I've used Civics over a few years for the odd extension, and it was, you know, obviously it writes a lot of, it sucks in a whole lot of boilerplate, and I was thinking, I bet that boilerplate's been updated in the time that I've written this extension. Like, is there any way to sort of make sure that the bits that I've written on my extension are sort of reapplied on top of the latest Civics boiler code?
So if we go to the Civics GitHub page, there's a file called upgrade.md, which describes how to update your extension to match those kinds of things. So most of the time, it's a matter of just regenerating the underlying the underlying file, which is mymodule.civics.php.
Mm-hmm.
If there's other boilerplate that cannot be handled there, then it will be documented. Go add this extra function somewhere. But it's designed to minimize how often that happens.
Nice. Yeah, that's never been a problem for me.
I've never noticed a problem, but then I haven't studied what's changed in Civics' output between then and now, like, so I just assume it works.
Mm-hmm. Okay, do we wrap up and see how the food is going?
Thanks.